Hey fam bam, welcome back to our channel. If you're new to this channel, then you'll know that I'm always with my wife, most of the time. Sometimes she's alone, like yesterday's video, she was all by herself. That's because she's not with me, you know, my Yoki Yoki is not here. Yeah, before you start singing the song, my Yoki Yoki, it's because we are equally yoked now. So I'm her yoke, she's my yoke, so together, you know, Yoki Yoki, you get what I mean, right? I just thought, let me sit down and let me have a little chat with you guys and let's just reflect back on this year. And I mean, wow, 2020, guys. 2020 is gonna go down in the Guinness Book of Records, like your World Book of Records, because like, this year has been. It's been going on, eh? It doesn't feel like it wants to end, but hey, guess what? We're in December, it's the final year of this year. But we're still living in this pandemic, but I just wanted to discuss, how are you? I just want to find out from you, how are you? Because man, let me be candid, let me be open. This year's been tough. Yo, this year has been tough on me, it's been tough on my wife. You know, for us, having gotten married last year and we're in our first year of marriage, like, can you imagine trying to understand each other, trying to build on our relationship that has now upgraded and it has matured to the marital state, you know? And then we under this pandemic. So trying to figure things out like that and having to work from home for myself and having her always at home and then she's gone sometimes. And it's been crazy. But nevertheless, we've also lost loved ones this year, and I'm sure you can relate, fam bam. Some of you have also lost loved ones. You may have even lost your job, some of you, and some of you may have even lost faith and hope and just the courage just to go on and just to hope and dream again. Some of you have lost your hopes and dreams, literally, and you're thinking, oh, what's life going to throw at me now? Because doors are closing, you know, there's no opportunities. Your business has gone down, or it's going down, or it's not booming, it's not scaling as you thought it would scale this year. You've tried a lot of things this year. You tried to be entrepreneurial, you tried to start up new things, but it's been tough, you know. I know how it feels. I sit here, you know my story, fam bam. I mean, I shared how I lost my job a couple of years back and how that also, it was a curveball, but you know what, through it all, I've just trusted in God and I've laid my trust in Jesus and He's come through for me, and that was my testimony. And I know that some of you are going through that right now, but I'm just here just to encourage you once again to say, you know what, trust in God, He's going to come through for you. Do not lose sight of Him, the author and perfecter of our faith. Don't lose sight of Him, because He's there and He's saying, listen, I know the pandemic is here. I know that it has shaken the world, but we are not of this world. We are in the world, but not of this world. Remember, we are kingdom-minded. We are seated in heavenly places. Picture that. We are seated in heavenly places. Where Christ is, as He is, so am I, so are you. Where He's seated, we're seated with Him, you know, and He's right there next to the Father. So, yeah, no, this year, I just wanted to say that this year has also been just, it's been, I don't even know how to put it. I literally don't know how to put it, because everywhere you go, people are just negative. Everybody is just saying, you know what, this year, it's the worst year ever. Let's redo the year, 2020 this, 2020 that. But what are you taking from 2020? 2020 happened, guys. It happened. We are living testimonies of this year. We're going to be telling our kids and grandkids all about this year. And what did you grab from 2020? You know, what are the lessons that you've picked up? You know, because I can tell you now, 2020 has shifted my mindset. My outlook on life has changed, you know, the way I approach work and business and the way I approach living in the moment and taking advantage of every moment, you know, just appreciating being around loved ones, appreciating, you know, just having people around me, because we are so used to it, you know, being social and out there. But this year has taught us that, listen, we have to be social virtually though. And, you know, it just speaks to how in touch are we with the people around us, you know? How often are you actually spending time with friends, with family? Have you called them? Have you heard of them? This year has separated us. It has put us in different corners. And now we're hearing of family members being ill and sick. Now you're hearing of family members going through the worst. And it just speaks to how in touch are we with one another. You know, we need to be there for each other. And the Bible even speaks about if you're in a place where you've been comforted by the Lord, you know, if you've went through some tough times and God has been there for you, the Bible speaks about us having to be now those individuals that have to comfort others. In fact, let's turn over to the Word of God. Let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 3 and 4. It reads as follows: All praise to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is our merciful Father and the source of all our comfort. Verse 4 says, He comforts us in all our troubles so that we can comfort others. When they are troubled, we will be able to give them the same comfort God has given us. And that's why I'm encouraging you, fam bam. I mean, we're all coming from different walks of life. We all are facing our own battles. You know, we're all in this concrete jungle of a world. You know, we're all just trying to make it. We're trying to keep afloat, you know. And I understand, fam bam. You know, I feel the cries. My heart is really breaking at this moment because I see a lot of you, fam bam, even others out there that I see on the social media platforms. You know, I see them, they are students, they need funding. And maybe you're one of those students that need funding to continue your studies next year. Your family can't support you no more. You know, maybe you've got parents and loved ones who are just not working anymore, have lost their jobs, and there's just nothing for you. You know, maybe those bursary schemes and those scholarships are no longer funding you. They don't want to fund you, and you just need to graduate. You want to graduate, but you just can't do it. My heart breaks out for you. You know, my heart really, I pray for you. You know, the least I can do is just pray. If I could, I'd just give you all the money that I could give you. But fortunately, hey, you know, we don't all have the funds to just share and give, but we know there are people that God can use to bless you. And so what we can do is more powerful, which is to pray and trust God to unlock those doors, to tap on the hearts of those who are able to give. And if you're that individual that is able to give, it does not matter how much, man. I've seen petitions of people saying, listen, just any little amount will do for me, just so that I can finish my studies, just so that I can graduate, just so that I can get food and feed my children. You know, I pray for you right now. In fact, I'm saying I pray for you, but I'm actually going to pray for you right now. So where you are right now, if you don't mind, just raise your hands and close your eyes, and let's just trust God right now to unlock doors for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you. I humble myself, and I know that right now there are individuals listening in, watching in. Father, I don't know their situation, Lord God. I don't know what they're facing right now. Your daughter right now, who's breaking, her heart is broken because, Lord Jesus, she needs funding for her schooling. Lord Jesus, she needs funds for her children. She needs to keep the roof over their heads. Father God, she needs, Father God, or he even needs that money for the job, Lord God, to support the family, Father, to provide. My God, I don't know their needs, but you do. So I pray right now in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, may you please work in their hearts, Lord God. May you comfort them right now. May you begin to bring out that faith, hallelujah, that faith that you have deposited in them. May it be shaken right now, and may it rise up right now in the name of Jesus. Because, Lord God, you said without faith, it is impossible to please you. So Father, I pray for those who are able to give and to bless them. My God, unlock doors for them in the name of Jesus, for jobs to be made available for them right now in the name of Jesus, for your children to finish their schooling, Father God, to graduate. My God, those who are ill and sick, Father God, they are those who are sitting right now, Father God, they I don't know what disease, virus, whatever it may be, Father, ailment and pain, Father, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. They are healed in Jesus' name, Father God. They are loved ones, they've got parents, they've got siblings, they've got aunts and uncles who are sick and ill. My God, I pray right now, by your stripes, Lord Jesus, you said we are healed. We're not going to be healed. We are already healed. It's already done at the cross of Calvary. We thank you that by your stripes, hallelujah, we are healed. And Lord Jesus, I thank you that right now you are beginning to raise us up, Father God. There's a faith that's being stirred up right now in us, Lord Jesus, that as we look into 2021, Father God, it's going to be a blessed year, Father God. We don't know what's coming, but we know who's already there, and that's you, Lord Jesus. You're already in 2021. So I speak a blessing over everybody, Father God, right now that's looking to 2021 and looking for hope, looking for a better, fresh start. Lord God, may you begin to do a wonderful thing in their lives, Lord God. And right now, we just thank you in advance, Lord Jesus. We're not going to moan, we're not going to sulk, Father God. We're going to thank you in advance for 2021 because it is already blessed, Father God, and we thank you right now in the name of Jesus. I pray, amen. Fam bam, I don't know who I just prayed for. I don't know. I think I prayed for myself actually, because now I needed that. I really needed that, and man. Fam bam, may 2021 be a blessed year for you, fam bam. I pray in the name of Jesus that indeed that you will look at 2020 and you'll see the lessons that we've learned. You'll see how God has kept you. Because if you're watching this video right now, that means God has brought you to this point, you know, and you're not watching this video by mistake. You're not here just to, you know, pass time. You're here to listen to what God is saying to you, because I'm listening right now and he's speaking to me as I speak to you. Because listen, God has been good. God is good, and he'll forever be good. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Like he was for the Israelites, he is for us today. He's doing it today. He's doing it for you. It's for us to receive. It's for us to believe. You know, if there's one thing that I love about God, and I said it in that prayer, that without faith, it's impossible to please him. We just have to come with faith and believe his word, believe his promises. His promises are yes and amen for me and for you, because we're believers. We know who we belong to. We are children of God. We are kingdom-minded priesthoods, royal priesthoods, a holy nation, a whole generation that is just meant to dominate this world. So I don't know what more to say, fam bam, but except that I love you guys, and I know Reho as well, she loves you too. We love you guys. We forever praying for you. We care for you, and if there's anything we can do for you, we will pray. We will pray. Whether you DM us on Instagram, you send us an email prayer request or prayer petition, we will pray for you. We'll pray with you, because this world, we need each other. You heard that scripture. When we have faced troubles and we have been comforted by God, now we can comfort you, because we've gone through the most as well. There's a lot we've gone through. Whoa, there's a lot. There's a whole lot we've gone through. But you know what? We are here for you. We love you. And I hope you have a blessed day today. I'll speak to you guys tomorrow. Yeah, until then, be blessed. Bye, fam bam.